Gaia is the electronic association located in the Basque Country area in Spain, and we are one of the partners of the Diana project. In our case, we are the responsible of the dissemination activities. In the few minutes I have, I just to give you a general vision of the Diana project. First of all, I just to say why the motivation of the project. While we are trying to give an answer to the urgent need to the reduction of energy consumption. In this area, energy consumption in buildings plays a crucial role because it's estimated that more than 40% of the energy consumption in Europe is building related. And how can we deal with the energy consumption in buildings? In the first place, EDIANA will enable a better management of the building's resources. And by building resources, we mean the devices that consume energy and also the means for energy generation and storage. And secondly, EDIANA seeks to make easier for end users to be aware of the energy consumption. The overall objective is the design, development, and demonstration and validation of the Diana platform, integrating intelligent embedded devices installed in residential and non-residential buildings for improving the energy efficiency. The Diana platform is a reference model-based architecture implemented through an open middleware that would enable the integration of all kinds of embedded devices, sensors, actuators, controllers, and embedded interface, independently of their manufacturing and including specification, design methods, tools, standards, and procedures for platform validation and verification. And what's the main innovation of this project? Well, we don't consider the building as an isolated entity, but also as an entity that can communicate with other buildings in the same area that are surrounding it. So we consider the energy efficiency like a strategy that can be taken at the district level. Secondly, in the building, we consider two levels of control. The first level of the low level is what we call cell level, is the unit, and we enable the interoperability for management of energy. And the higher level, what we call macro cell, is the building itself. We manage energy production and storage and common in the common areas and the global energy efficiency decisions. Our objective, more or less, is that we expect to achieve a 25% of energy consumption in residential and non-residential buildings across the different climate areas of Europe. We also prove, through intensive demonstration experience, a significant improvement of consumer satisfaction, with new means that EDIANA will provide for controlling household devices and for awareness of energy consumption. And at the end, we will enable a model for building to become an active factor in the energy market, as they will be able to sell the energy that they produce. It's a model where we call prosumer model, that is a combination of consumer and producer of energy. For the working tasks in the EDIANA, we have some technical aspects and some non-technical aspects. The main technical aspect that we are working on is identify and formalize the EDIANA baseline and the specifications, the formalization and application of new model-driven requirements management technique, definition of EDIANA reference architecture, the development at EDIANA platform cell and macro cell level devices, and to apply a new technique methods and tools assistant techniques validation and verification process. We are also to develop some pre-industrial demonstration and some real scale demonstration. We expect to develop two pre-industrial demonstrations, one in Spain and one in Italy, and four real scale demonstrations. And at the end, the exploitation and dissemination of the project. Where are we now? Now we are finalizing the requirement specifications that we hope will be ready for the early next year. By the middle of the next year, we are going to develop the pre-industrial prototypes, and for the year 2011, we are going to work in the real scale demonstrations. And so just to finalize, this is the list of the partners that are working in this project. And I have to say that this project was granted by the first call of the Joran de Tarkin Artemis platform. And that's all. I'm going to be here. If you have any question, maybe now, not now, but if you you can contact me or the coordinator of the project, that is Acciona. And that's all.